Hello everyone, my name is Dea Eniarisida Butar. I'm from Biology Education, Maritim Raja Ali Haji University. My ID student 21030300044. I want to explain about plant body structure or organization. English course of biology. Plant body structure and organization in Indonesian language is struktur dan organisasi tumbuhan. The first, I want to explain about tissue classification in plants. Tissue classification in plants, tissue is a tissue composed of cells that have the ability to totipotential, which is different from animal tissue. Plant tissue is a tissue that have the ability, if this plant organism can reproduce itself negatively, considering the ability of the plant's body to consist of cell. Plants are grouped into six kits, including the following. The first is meristem tissue. Meristem tissue in the young tissue of group of actively dividing plant cell. Cell meristem will produce new cells with some of the result of division will remain in the meristem. These are referred to as starting or initial cells. The second is permanent network or adult. Permanent tissue is non-meristematic tissue. Network non-meristematic tissue whose cell do not divide anymore. Permanent network formed from the division of meristem cell with consist of primary and meristem, secondary meristem, with include permanent tissue, epidermal tissue, parenchyma tissue, support network, transport network, and cord network. The first is epidermal tissue. The main structure of epidermal tissue is as the utmost protector of every plant's organ. In addition, the epidermis becomes a place of exchange of substance and becomes of one of the effects of air due to evaporation. Other forms of epidermis are stomata, trichome, spines, and filaments. The second is parenchyma tissue. Parenchyma tissue is the basic tissue found in almost all plant organs. Parenchyma tissue is also the reference to as ground tissue. The next is supporting tissue. This tissue is also called mechanical tissue because it has a function to supporting shape of the plant so that it can stand filmy and strong. There are two kinds of supporting tissue, namely collenchyma and sclerenchyma tissue. Next is transport network. This network serves to transport water, elements, and food substance from photosynthesis from one part to another. There are two types of transport tissue, namely xylem and phloem. Xylem is a vessel that carries air and nutrition from the roots to the leaves, while the phloem or sieve tubes are transport tissue that function to transport food substance from photosynthesis from the leaves to the rest of the body. Next is cord tissue. Cord tissue is found in many tools in plants and is composite of cord. Parenchyma cell. The function of cord tissue is to replace epidermal tissue as a barrier, prevent evaporation, and protect against mechanical damage and pathogen infection. Next is tissue that make up plant organisms. Roots, stems, leaves, root structure network. The first is root structure network. As for the network structure consisting of the roots from the outside to the inside of the cross section, functions of the following networks. The first is epidermis. The epidermis has root, hairs as the activity of cell behind the growing point that function expand the obstruction area. The second is cortex. The cortex is a tissue that serves a place to store food reserve. Next is endodermis. The endodermis is a layer of cells that separates the cortex and the stele. Next is stele. The central stele or cylinder is the network that function as a means of transporting water and minerals throughout the plant anatomy. Next is trunk composition network structure. The anatomical structure of trunk consists of constituent tissue from outside to inside. Following, the first is epidermis. The epidermis on the stem undergoes secondary growth. The epidermal layers is replaced by layer of cork formed from the cork cambium. The second is cortex. Cortex is the outermost part of the system, the stem or root of a plant, which is limited on the outside by the epidermis and internally by the endodermis. The next is the stele. The stele in the stem consists of vessel and parenchyma of leaf stills, pit and pericycle. Stele or the central cylinder is the innermost part of the root. The next is leaf composition network structure. The first is the epidermis. The epidermis on the outer wall of the leaf is covered with a cuticle which function to reduce evaporation water. The next is parenchyma. Parenchyma or mesophyll in leaf serves as a place for photosynthesis to take place. Well, that might explain about plant body structure and organization. Thank you for your attention. See you to next video. Bye-bye.